Assalamualaikum everyone. So today we are going to discuss the second question from our topical 5. We need to express the following trigonometric functions in terms of trigonometric ratios of acute angles. So take note here, we need to refer back to acute angles, meaning we need to refer to our reference angle. Okay, so it's either reference angle or our basic angle, which means we are going to refer back to our alpha. And then hence, find each value using a calculator. So first, what we need to do is we need to draw our quadrant, which means we need to draw simple one because we just want to refer the position for our theta. So here our theta is 235 degrees and we know that 235 degrees will be in the third quadrant. So more or less we can draw the angle here. This is our terminal side, and since our theta is equal to a positive angle, we can just label that theta is equal to 235 degrees, and from there we know that we can find our alpha using the formula alpha is equal to theta minus 180 degrees because it is in the third quadrant. Okay, so here our theta is 235 degrees minus 180 degrees, that will give us 55 degrees. So now we know here our alpha is equal to 55 degrees, and we can just calculate secant in the third quadrant. So before we calculate secant in the third quadrant, what we have to refer back to is add sugar to coffee. These four letters represent which trigonometric ratios will be positive in which quadrant. So we need to calculate secant. Secant 235 degrees, and it is located in the third quadrant. And secant, we know by the definition, secant will be equal to 1 over cos. So we have 1 over cos 235 degrees, and in the third quadrant cos will be negative, so we can just rewrite this as negative cos, and then we just change our theta into alpha, so cos 55 degrees. So now we are going to calculate this using a calculator, and we can just key in cos 55 in the calculator. We take the negative upwards, and then what we have here is cos 55 is 0.5736. Okay, so from there we can just calculate again, 1 divided by 0.5736 will be equal to negative 1.7434, and that is our solution for secant 235 degrees. Next, we have cosecant of 128 degrees. So here again, what we need to do is we are going to first draw our quadrants, and we are going to have my is here, and 128 degrees will be located in the second quadrant. It is in the second quadrant. I can just draw it immediately like that, and then we are going to label our angle. So my angle will go in anticlockwise direction. Theta is 128 degrees, and again we are going to refer back to add sugar to coffee. I'll just rewrite everything first before we start answering the question. So here we can find our alpha using the formula alpha is equal to 180 degrees minus theta, since our theta is in the second quadrant. So I'll just take 180 degrees minus 128 degrees, and that will give me 52 degrees. So now I have here alpha is equal to 52 degrees, and what I need to calculate is cosecant of 128 degrees, and by the definition we know that it will be 1 over sine. Okay, so I will have here 1 divided by sine of 128 degrees, and since my theta is in the second quadrant and I know sine theta will be positive here, I can just rewrite this as 1 over sine of alpha, which is 52 degrees. And now calculating sine 52 degrees in the calculator will give me divided by 0.7880. So now we just need to calculate 1 divided by 0.7880, and that will give 0.269, and that is the solution for cosecant of 128 degrees. Next, let's take a look at the third example. We have cotangent of 11/6π. So for the first step here, what we are going to do is just change back everything to degrees. To change back to degree, again we are going to use the formula theta times 180 degrees divided by pi. Here our theta is 11/6π, so just calculating that, 11/6 pi times 180 degrees divided by pi will be equal to 330 degrees. Okay, so now I know what I need to find here is actually cotangent of 330 degrees. So now again we are going to first draw the quadrant where 330 degrees lies. The next we are going to locate where 330 degrees are located. So 330 degrees will be in the fourth quadrant, and I can just label there my terminal side. And then once we have located our angle, we just need to label everything. And since that is still a positive angle, I will have my theta here is 330 degrees. And from there, I know that I can find my reference angle, which is alpha. So alpha in the fourth quadrant will be 360 degrees minus theta, which is 330 degrees, and that gives me 30 degrees. I need to evaluate the value for cot 11 over 6 pi. So cot 11 over 6 pi, which is also equal to cot of 330 degrees, is actually equal to, by the definition, it will be 1 over tangent. So I can just rewrite this as 1 over tangent of 330 degrees. And since my theta is located in the fourth quadrant, we know that we have add sugar to coffee, and tangent theta in the fourth quadrant will be negative. So we just change that into 1 over negative tangent and change my theta into alpha, tangent 30 degrees. So you can use formula here, or you can also use our special angles. We have our triangle here, which is 60 degrees and 30 degrees. And then we have the right angle there. And then we have 2, 1 and 3. So here we can just immediately take the value for tangent 30 will be opposite over adjacent. So we get here 1 over 3. And then what we will get here is negative 1 times 3. So my answer will be negative 2. And let's continue with the fourth example. So we have sine of 488 degrees. So here as previously, because we know here our theta is greater than 360 degrees, so we need to check first how much did we exceed 360 degrees. So first we just take 488 degrees minus 360 degrees, and that will give me 128 degrees. So now I know that 488 degrees will be located in, now I have one full rotation, and since the angle exceeds one full rotation, I need to label here 450 degrees and then 540 degrees. And I can see that my angle will be in the third quadrant of 88 degrees. So I just label my terminal side there. And then we are going to label the rotation for our angle. We are going to start the initial side, and then it will end in the second quadrant. Theta is 488 degrees. So again, we need to define what is our alpha. So to find alpha, we just use the formula alpha is equal to 180 degrees minus, we take how much we exceed 360 degrees just now, so 128 degrees. So here we will get 52 degrees. So now, I can just label here alpha is 52 degrees, and we can also immediately rewrite add sugar to coffee because we need to refer this again later, and we need to evaluate sine 488 degrees. This can also be written as, because sine in the second quadrant will be positive, so we just get the positive value there, and then sine of alpha. So our alpha will be 52 degrees. So now we are going to evaluate sine 52 degrees, and what we will have is 0.7880, and that is our solution. Next, we are going to look at cos of 685 degrees. So for this one, again, we are going to try and locate the position of theta. So to do that, first we need to know how much did we exceed our one full rotation, which is 360 degrees. So we are going to take 685 degrees minus 360 degrees, and that will give us 325 degrees. So now I can just draw my different. And what I will have here is 0 degree, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, 360 degrees, and then 450 degrees, 540 degrees, 730 degrees, as well as 720 degrees. So now I know that my angle will be located in the fourth quadrant. So I can just draw the terminal like that. And again, as usual, we are going to label our theta. So we are going almost like two full rotation. So our theta is 685 degrees. Okay. So now we need to label our alpha. So again, to find alpha, since it is in the fourth quadrant, we know that we can take 360 degrees minus 325 degrees, and that will give me 35 degrees for our alpha. So alpha is equal to 35 degrees here. And now we need to evaluate cos of 685 degrees. We know that we have added sugar to coffee, and we can just see that cos of theta will be positive. So we just change our theta into our alpha, which is 35 degrees. So now again, we are going to calculate cos 35, which is equal to 0.8192. Okay, so that is our solution. Cos of 685 degrees will be equal to 0.8192, and that is the final answer. Plus, we will have tangent of 936 degrees. So here, there is an extra caution for you to see, because we have one full rotation is equal to 360 degrees. So if we have two rotation, we will have 720 degrees. So if we see here, our theta exceeds 720 degrees, so we need to calculate. If we have 3 rotation, that will be 1080 degrees. So we need to take note here, we have to be careful. So to find how much did we exceed, we need to take 966 degrees minus 720 degrees, and we know we exceed the 2 full rotation by 216 degrees. So now again, we are going to locate our angle, and we can just label the rotation from 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270, 360 degrees, and then we will have 450, 540, 650 degrees, and lastly 720 degrees. You can also label for the third rotation, but I will stop there, because now we know, because we exceed the two full rotation by 216 degrees, so now 216 degrees will be located in the third quadrant. I just need to label my terminal side there, and now I'm going to label the rotation of my angle. We're going to start at 0 degree, one full rotation, two full rotation, and I ended up at my terminal side there. So theta is 906 degrees. Again, we need to find our reference angle. So our alpha will be equal to, since it is in the third quadrant, we are going to take theta minus 180 degrees, and our theta, we will assume it will be 216 minus 180 degrees, which will be 36 degrees. Okay, so now we have alpha is 36 degrees here. Next, what we need to do is evaluate tangent of 936 degrees. So add sugar to coffee, and we know tangent theta in the third quadrant will always be positive. We can just rewrite that as positive tangent alpha, which is 36 degrees. So now we just need to evaluate tangent 36 degrees, and by using our calculator, we will get this is 0.7265, and that is our final answer.